now back with us on the show. Now, all this time we've been speaking about so many different aspects of an amazing, a young personality who is here making waves in Sri Lanka. And I keep repeating that because she is doing that.
She is doing that.
And we always try to bring you the some of the most interesting personalities in Sri Lanka. And these are not people that even Anupama or I would come across in our daily routines as well. But there are people who are here on the show with us, and we get to share their stories with you. And that's a privilege for the both of us as well. Thank you so much, Sharana, for being with us.
It's a huge privilege for me to be here, so thank you very much for having me here.
Definitely. And you're a bubbly personality to have on the show. Now, we've spoken about your work as a part of the Unity Mission Trust, as well as being a research analyst and being the president of the Toastmasters Club of APIT. But let's speak about your future plans. Now, I'm sure that someone like you have something in the works at the moment as well.
Written down officially.
And there's some goal or target there for sure. Let's speak about your future plans. 2014, it's a brand new year.
It's panning out to be a very very exciting year so far. One of the things I'm very excited about is I'm getting involved with Earth Hour Sri Lanka. I was part of we founded Colombo Green Walk, which did a walk back in 2012, I believe it was, which was to raise awareness for environmental issues. Earth Hour Sri Lanka, those who know the Earth Hour organization, has a branch in Sri Lanka. So I'm hoping to get a little more involved with them. And they have a new tagline, they're going blue.
Going blue.
So raising awareness about oceanic issues as well, which includes the environment. And definitely. Also the going green tag is a bit been there, done that.
It would take a double take when you say going blue.
It gains more attention. So I'm very excited about getting involved with that. I'm also looking to see, to expand my work in the north a little bit. I want to see if we can try and do some soft skill training. Not just in the north, but hopefully take it outside of Sri Lanka as well.
So take the sort of skills you gained in
CV writing.
Who are you? Focus on here?
Ideally, school children leavers? Just out availables.
Right. School leavers.
School leavers, university students. It's just a vague idea that I have in my head that I'm hoping to, you know, come up with more concrete plans.
No, but it's really important because, you know, sometimes you get into, students get into a lot of technical practice.
Oh, yeah.
And then not really, most students that I know personally who are coming out of school, they actually don't know how to write a proper CV or a cover letter or even go and face an interview properly unless they Google it up. And, you know, most children in Sri Lanka do not have the facility of Googling it up.
Oh, yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Especially talking about people who are outside Colombo.
Exactly.
So, yeah, that's a very interesting
I'm firming up plans and trying to see, I'm seeing if I can do it through Unity Mission Trust, and I have a few interested parties that I've come across who are willing to help me, so very excited about that.
It sounds exciting.
Yes, it really is.
And other than that, we are going to continue, you know, maybe a master's in law or anything like that?
I've decided against a master's in law at the moment. I haven't decided what I'm going to do for my master's yet, but I'm exploring various options. I have immersed myself in so many things now that I kind of want to take it all in and take it step by step and
maybe that's
where
important as well, not to have too many things on your plate as well, but
definitely
to really enjoy what you have at the moment as
well. Definitely.
And when you speak about what you expect to see in Sri Lanka, now you are someone who actually has more exposure than most of us to the kind of policy making, the kind of view that, you know, even the international community have about Sri Lanka, things like that. Where do you see Sri Lanka going in the next year and maybe even the next 5 years?
I think we have an amazing younger generation, and I'm talking about, you know, those in their 20s and 30s who are very committed to rebuilding Sri Lanka, and a lot more people are coming back. A lot more people see the value of investing in our own nation rather than taking these skills elsewhere. And if that continues, I see a very hopeful future for Sri Lanka, because those young people don't only focus on their skills, they focus on spreading those skills to other people. So, and I've met wonderful members of the diaspora, you know, who have come back to Sri Lanka and who are investing their skills in here and, you know, working and doing amazing things. So if
really
that continues, and if that continues, and if we continue to see that trend, I see a very positive future for Sri Lanka, because, you know, in the end, it lies in the hands of our generation. And we can either kind of go, oh, it doesn't matter. Or we can go, you know, it actually does. It makes a difference. What we do today actually will make a difference tomorrow. And I think most of my generation does think that way. They do think, you know what, it does matter what we do tomorrow. And, you know, we feel we feel that our parents' generation in a way failed us because they failed to stop the war. Mm-hmm. That was a failure on our parents' generation. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But now it's no longer their turn, it's our turn now. So we can either complain about what they left us, or we can lead the same thing for our children, or we can work on fixing it.
Oh, so that's an amazing message coming out for our studio this morning to your homes as well. I hope that that inspired a lot of people to really take up the challenge, because it does not be big things.
No, right? Not at all.
It can be very small things that you do, even the way you think and the way you open up your mind to different people and to different possibilities. I mean, I'm sure that's going to make a big change as well. We never spoke about the second reason that she went viral this year. Yeah, that's a very interesting interview. Did you see that interview?
Yes, I did.
Sharanya actually did a live TV interview on Sky News, which is a station that's in UK, is it?
That's right. Yeah.
That's right. And she was featured there, and they asked her some tough questions during that interview.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they did not go easy on it. Let's talk about that experience just for a little while, because that went viral as well, and you got a lot of attention because of that.
Yeah, the response for that was incredibly heartwarming, incredibly touching. What happened was, one of the producers follows me on Twitter. Mm-hmm. So she, and you know, I didn't have much time to really think about it, because she contacted me, I think it's about 6 when she contacted me and said, listen, we want to do this interview, we want to talk about, we want young faces, we want to see youth talking about Chogam and impact on Sri Lanka, and are you interested? So I called my boss, because obviously, you know, he's the first person I need to say, is this okay with you? You know, are there any lines? And I spoke to him and I said, okay, you know, I'm fine. Originally, I was supposed to go to their studios, but they couldn't get me the credentials. So they were like, okay, we'll do it from Skype, we'll do it from your home. And like, so 6 o'clock, I get the call, and 8:30, I'm doing the interview.
Wow.
So I didn't have time. I still have no memory of that entire interview.
But it's all up there on YouTube.
I know, it's recorded, right? Thankfully. They sent me, they were very nice. They sent me the clip. And they did ask me some tough questions. I didn't see that coming.
Yeah. I mean,
I didn't, but...
it was from autocracy to, you know,
some big words. And I was like, I was like, process it slowly.
No, but you did not sound uncomfortable at all.
Toastmasters.
Literally,
though, a lot of people said, you know, you sounded very confident, poison. I said, yes, because I have been doing impromptu speaking. I have been trained for this. Yes. This is my moment. But no, Toastmasters was a huge part of the reason I did as well as I did in that interview. Mm-hmm. And it was a rattling experience, know, but it was also one of the highs of last year completely.
So you were really happy with how it came out when you saw I'm sure you didn't know what you said at that time.
No, actually, I did the voice recording.
Okay.
So I listened to it later and I was like, that's what I said.
So what about the feedback that you got immediately afterwards?
I have got some wonderful feedback from, you know, different people. Mm-hmm. I mean, you've had the criticism, but that's to be expected.
Definitely.
But a lot of people have been very encouraging. And, you know, that has translated to a lot of interest, because I mentioned that I do work in the North, and then people have asked me, what is the work in the North you do? So I've been able to promote Unity Mission Trust through that as well.
Yeah.
Because to me, that's the important thing. I mean, you know, all these opportunities are great, but you have to take the opportunity and make use of it and do something
with it. That's
also
very true.
You know, it's really important that you try and do that. So... I have been able to, so
and
it's
sure
been great.
Our viewers out there would love to follow you as well.
Yes,
I mean, the youngsters out there, as well as even, you know, some of the more mature audience that we have, I'm sure would love to hear your opinion, a voice of the youth speaking out. So how can they follow you?
Okay, so if you want to listen to my nonsensical thoughts occasionally, it's occasional that they're nonsensical. I'm on Twitter, so you can follow me at Shara Sekaram.
Okay.
So it's my abbreviated first name and Sekaram. You can also, I post fairly regularly on my blog, which is sharanya-sekaram.blogspot.com.
All right.
So that's how you can find my little voice.
And it's not a little voice, it's a big voice, and she's using it in the correct way, I'm sure.
Yes.
But Anupama.
Yes, sorry, I was just wondering, how can people get to know about what's going on with UMT? And you said that there was a Facebook page.
Yep, so Unity Mission Trust has a Facebook page, which if you search for Unity Mission Trust within brackets UMT, most of the information is on our website, though.
Right.
So anybody who's interested, I highly recommend you go to our website, which is unitymission.lk.
Okay.
But also on Twitter. So I'm a big advocate of Twitter. I think it's such a fantastic social media tool.
Mm-hmm.
So we're on Twitter at Unity Mission. But unitymission.lk is the most cohesive place to go to find out the basics about who we are, how we function.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
So with that, I think we've come to the end of our show, Shirani.
Yes.
Thank you so much. You shared so much of a lot of inspiring messages
and
coming out of this show.
Haven't we, Amaya?
We have. And it's a humbling experience to meet you as well, all the work.
Humbling experience to be here.
Thank you so much for being with us on the show. Anupama, I think it's time for us to wrap up the show today. This morning.
Unfortunately. So we'll be seeing you tomorrow. Same time and with another very interesting person.
Definitely.
As Amaya always says, we have interesting people coming up tomorrow.
Like Sharanya.
So today is an all-girls show, but tomorrow, you never know.
Hey, a little girl power never hurt anybody. I love this show.
Yeah, I know. I love this, but it's actually, you know, one of the most interesting shows that I've been into personally. Mm-hmm. So
definitely.
Cool. We'll be seeing you.
We wish you a great day and we'll see you tomorrow.
Have a good day.